Good morning, student. Welcome to the class. Presentation today we'll discuss a new chapter, presentation with Microsoft PowerPoint. So PowerPoint is very familiar to you. So we'll start from the introduction. PowerPoint is a multimedia presentation software. It is a part of Microsoft Office package of application. Microsoft PowerPoint software is used to create professional looking slideshow that can be displayed on projectors or big screen television. That you are knowing about the PowerPoint. So it shows a big slideshow that shows in a big screen or projector. The product of this software is called a presentation. Usually a presenter speaks to the audience and uses the PowerPoint presentation for visual and hold the listeners' attention and add visual information. So if you are giving any presentation, so you have to make that presentation very attractive. Attractive means very attractive, only no need to write only the contents. You have to send some pictures also, you have to put some pictures also, some graph, some charts also. So the audience, we are seeing your presentation, they might be only eye contact with your presentations only, and write the contents very easy form. So those who are reading, those who are listening your presentation, they will understand very quickly. Like this you have to make the presentation. PowerPoint is an easy to learn program that is used worldwide for presentation in business and classrooms. PowerPoint presentations are equally suitable for huge audience and small groups, where they can be used for educational, marketing, training and other purpose. So where you are using the PowerPoint presentation for your business purpose, if you are having the huge audience and you have to explain something, so there you have to use. An education purpose also, marketing you are giving that advertisements of your product. So there, while giving the advertisement of your product, then the audience will buy the product. So you have to give the presentation what is there in your product and what are the benefits of the product which you have made. Then training purpose, if you are giving training to someone or in any staff or any group, so with the help of this presentation also you are able to give the proper explain the way. Then getting to PowerPoint, how to start the PowerPoint, this procedure is given here. To get a PowerPoint, click start, then go to the all programs, go to Microsoft Office 2010, then PowerPoint 2010 or types of PowerPoint in Windows operating system, search box. The PowerPoint window opens up showing a blank presentations. When you start PowerPoint, it opens in the normal view where you created and work on slides. So here it is given the Windows picture image of PowerPoint, and all the tools we are using, this all given in the as a label, and the middle business placeholder. Click to add. From here we are starting our presentations. So come to the components of PowerPoint presentation. First one is title bar. The title bar displays the name of the presentation on which you are working currently. So title bar means you are giving, if you are opening the PowerPoint presentation window, the presentation window at the top, it is given there, that is the title bar. Then ribbon. The ribbon contains 8 tabs: file, home, insert, page layout, reference, mailing, review and view. Each tab has several groups. So while clicking the file, under the file, if your tools are there, by clicking the home button, where too many tools are there, the tools is known as a groups, and this is known as a ribbon. That file, home, insert is known as a ribbon. Then quick access toolbar let us access common command on the ribbon. Defaults, it includes the save, undo typing, repeat typing commands. You can add another commands uses through this customize button also. So if while making the presentation, if you are notice that some tools you are using repeatedly, so you can put your tool to this quick access toolbar while using repeatedly. This quick access toolbar helps. Then slide pane. In the slide pane, you can work directly on individuals or individual slides. A presentation is made up of a series of slide pin. So left side slide pin is there. There you have to select the slides and save also. Slide and outline tab. The slide tab shows a thumbnail version of each full slide shows in the slide pin. You can copy, paste, delete, organize the slide in the slide tab. So left side the tab is visible. If you want to select sequentially or if you want to delete, if you want to add from there, you can add the slides. Then come to the placeholder. Placeholder hold text, clip arts, charts and other objects that you want to place in the slide. So the slide part is known as the placeholder, where you want to insert an image, clip arts, video, MP3s, videos, what you want to add on your presentation with the help of this placeholder, you are able to add. Note pens. If you want to give some note, then you at the bottom it is given that note, you can write the messages. Status bar. Status bar shows that total number of slides you are using. Then here it shows means which in which slides you are current working. Like this, the slide status bar will show. Horizontal and vertical scroll bar also helps for scrolling the slide. Then come to the creating the first slide. PowerPoint by default displays the title slides when loaded. To create the first slide, types of the title presentation by clicking add, then type suitable for click to add subtitle. First title is given there and second one is subtitle. If you are having the subtitle, then you can write, otherwise leave it. Using a slide layout. After completing your title slide, you can add more slide. Slide C, slide layouts is given here. So you have to plan first about your presentation and which type of slide you want. That slide you select from slide layout and then insert in your presentation slides. So first of all, you have to select plan your presentation and then select the slide from here. How to select is given there. Click on the new slide and slide groups of the home tab, it is given. From there you have to select the layout and then placeholder will come to the placeholder, and there you can insert or write your content of the presentation. Then PowerPoint provides us several ways for viewing presentation. These are normal view, slide sorter view, slide short view and reading view. So this view will explain in the next chapter. So first of all, if you are having the desktop or laptop in your home, so first you do this practical work, and then next topic, viewing the presentation, how to view, I will explain you in the next chapter. Thank you.